The start of the new school year hasn't been without complications. Just weeks in, and districts are battling a number of challenges. Staffing shortages, continued cleanup from Tropical Storm Ida, and now the start of COVID outbreaks, forcing some classes, even entire schools, to temporarily switch to virtual learning. So far, hundreds of positive COVID-19 cases have been reported in districts around the state, though the full extent of the situation is unclear because the state's COVID dashboard, a data tracking system, is behind on updates, and there's no requirement for districts to make the information public. Still, superintendents report being on far better footing to start this September, yet the patchwork approach to quarantining and closures is leaving some parents confused. Joanna Gagas reports.
Three individuals tested positive for the COVID-19. So starting today, that class will be learning remotely.
The COVID outbreak in a fourth grade Jersey City class is among the 13 positive cases reported by the district in just these first few weeks of school. And the state's second largest school system is just one of many districts around the state dealing with COVID outbreaks already. In Robbinsville, more than 220 students are currently in quarantine, as the superintendent shared with the district last week.
Over the past week, we have had a full classroom over at Charon having to quarantine. Last night, we had to quarantine over 75 students at Pond, girls that tried out for the soccer team. And we have three unrelated outbreaks or infections here at the high school, which means our school is considered an outbreak.
Yet even with those numbers, only the high school is closed for virtual learning. Quite different than in West Windsor Plainsboro, where the entire Maurice Hawk Elementary School went virtual after five reported cases. Superintendent David Adderhold explained in a letter to the community that the closure was made out of an abundance of caution, but grounded in the knowledge that four of the last five reported cases fall outside of any identified contact tracing and substantiate the potential of greater spread within our school community. How and when to close schools is a decision that's left to the districts, and it can be hard to find consistency. In New Providence, one full sixth grade class is quarantined, along with portions of two other classes, after positive cases began plaguing the district in the first week.
The very first day was actually mask optional policy, which was Wednesday of the first full week of September. And by Friday, there were three positive cases identified at the elementary school, which led to a large number of people being put in quarantine due to contact tracing purposes.
Stacy Gunderman has two kids in the elementary school with the quarantined class. She's concerned that new cases popping up since the quarantine might mean that more in-school transmission is happening.
There were additional cases reported last week, including some that had to, again, be contact traced, which means it wasn't coming from the quarantined kids from the first exposure. Nothing's been classified by the district as in-school transmission, yet as a parent, it's uncomfortable. And we'd like to know a little bit more, especially what the criteria is for deeming something in-school transmission.
The Department of Education's guidance leaves it to the districts to identify which students are close contacts of a positive person, whether there's been in-school transmission, and to communicate it back to their local health departments. But according to state epidemiologist Dr. Christina Tan,
we define an outbreak, an in-school in-school transmission outbreak, to be three or more epidemiologically linked cases where you don't have any household contacts among them, and that there might be some common activity or contact. Certainly, we do recognize that there might be sporadic cases, one-off cases in schools that might not that might just exist on its own.
But parents are left watching and waiting as more and more cases pop up in schools across the state to see if and how their districts will react. For NJ Spotlight News, I'm Joanna Gagas.